this shot of the London Eye framed by the absolute nonsense that is central London feels like a great way to start the day. So instant photography, activate, hooray. This is gonna be a fun day. This is gonna be a good day. It is an incredibly sunny day today here in London, so I'm wearing my sunglasses so I don't go blind, and I'm wearing my hat so that my face does not burn to a crisp. But more importantly than any of that, this is the Instankon RF70. It is an instant camera that uses Instax Wide film to take instant photos. It has full manual controls, which is very excellent. And it has an adorable little pop-up flash that we will not need to use today. If you do want to pick up one of these cameras, I really do recommend getting the ND filter set, because maximum shutter speed 1/500th of a second, incredibly sunny day, doesn't really work. I also have downloaded on my phone this light meter app that will tell me whether or not I am exposing correctly. I'm not very good at using it yet, so the odds are good that I will expose incorrectly regardless, but at least now I have something else to blame. There are some photos on the screen of photos that I've taken with this camera already, but I haven't taken it out in London yet. So let's go and do that, shall we? What better place to start on a bright sunny day than by the river, where all of the tourist things are? Because realistically, if I'm going to be taking photos of this lovely thing, they need to be tourist photos, don't they? Do they? They will be. I don't know if they need to be, but they will be. I will be taking all my photos today in portrait format. You can obviously take photos, I will be taking all my photos today in landscape format. You can obviously just turn the camera sideways and take them portrait, but then you've got this weird, not symmetrical, this bit sticks out a bit further, and I don't like it. Yes, better, good. Mwah. Our first touristy spot here in London is going to be this bridge in Westminster, which I assume is called Westminster Bridge. You can hear Big Ben binging and bonging behind me. We're walking along the bridge to try and get all of that in the shot. This will just about do it for distance. So what we're just going to do, we're going to line the shot up now and wait for something like, ooh, there's a London bus coming over there. So if we wait until that's kind of here-ish in the frame, then that'll really drive home the point that we were in fact tourists in London. And 3, 2, bus, go. That's probably come out fine. So this is basically us. We're just gonna wander around near the river, look at all the tourist things, take photos of all of the tourist things. I think that sounds like a pretty good day. No? Yes? Maybe? Under this underpass, you do have a really cool shot of Westminster and the big tower, but it does smell like wee. It really, really just smells like wee down here. This is the shot that will forever be, you know, tainted by the smell of wee, but you get the tower at Westminster in this little arch, and let's actually make sure it's in focus, which it isn't. This camera makes an absolutely brilliant noise when it's printing the photos. It sounds like it's in pain. I don't think it's in pain. No tourist day in London is complete without at least a second photo of the London Eye, especially against these lovely, wonderful, magnificent blue skies. As I'm sure you can tell from those last couple of photos, I haven't quite got the hang of exposing these correctly yet. They're all coming out a little bit wrong in one way or another. But I think that's part of the fun with instant photography, is that you're never 100% sure of what you're gonna get. Although with that said, with a light meter, manual controls, and my big smart human brain, I probably should be able to do this a bit better than I am. Oh, bye pigeon. Actually, do you know what? I think I've seen the flaw in the plan there, because big and smart are definitely not two words that describe my brain, especially when the sun is out and I'm essentially cooking it like a scrambled eggs. This video is just gonna be me wandering around London taking photos. There's no deeper how-to message in this video, partially because I thought it'd be more fun to just wander around and take photos, and partially because I don't know how to. If you want me to make a video on how to, I can certainly go and learn and then make a video. Leave a comment, let me know, what do you want to see? Do you want to see anything more specific about this camera? Or are you firmly and squarely in camp, make with the photos photography, man, go, go, go. Either way, leave a comment, let me know. Here's a question, can we use the instant camera for wildlife photography? Here's another question. Is a pigeon wildlife? I'm a bit too far away. I'm going to try and get a little bit closer, but I don't want to spook them. I'm sorry, it's okay. I'm not going to hurt you. Cuckoo! I'm trying to speak its language to keep it calm.
Okay, Bartholomew, if you could just stay very still for me. I have decided that the pigeon is named Bartholomew. Thank you, Well, I tried to say Bartholomew and instead nearly punched a pigeon. I don't really know what kind of brain malfunction has to happen to do that, but that's where we currently are. I did Bartholomew the pigeon's portrait at f5.6, which is the widest aperture that this camera goes to. And I have to say, that bokeh is actually ridiculous. That's very smooth. That's really, that's much better than I thought it was gonna be. This is genuine surprise now. One of the best reasons to be doing photography in London is the skyline. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? What I love about this particular spot is old on the left, new on the right. Just beautiful. There is something special about just wandering around a massive city and looking at all the cool buildings and all the old buildings and all the new buildings and 7,000 pigeons. This is quite a cool spot. You can't actually see it because it's all whited out in the middle, but you can see St. Paul's through this kind of weird framing. So, instant photo opportunity? Yes, good instant photo opportunity. It's on the screen, you tell me, because it hasn't developed yet and I don't know at this present time. This is one of my favorite spots in London for taking a photo of St. Paul's and a photo of the skyline, because you've got the arched bridge here just making a really, really cool frame. This lens isn't quite wide enough to get the skyline and St. Paul's into the same photo, but I have got some elements in there. I've got St. Paul's, there were a couple of boats going by on the river for a bit more interest. The photo hasn't finished developing yet, so I'm trying to do this from memory. Maybe I shouldn't do that. Maybe I should just wait the 1 minute it takes for the photo to develop. Yeah, there we go. I've got St. Paul's, I've got a bit of the bridge, I've got a boat, another boat, a crane. There's all sorts happening in this photo. The little LCD screen is telling me that I have two photos left, and of course, both of them are going to be photos of St. Paul's. The first photo of St. Paul's is going to be a classic, stood on that spot over there, looking straight up the bridge towards St. Paul's for that lovely symmetry, which we may not be able to get with the rangefinder instant camera, but it's on the screen. It may be symmetrical, it may be not, but either way, it's a photo of St. Paul's, and I love it. And for our final shot of St. Paul's, we're going to cross all the way over the bridge, go to the little shopping centre next door, and get the photo surrounded by all the glass and reflections. You'll see what I'm talking about in just a now. See what I mean? Glass absolutely everywhere. And St. Paul's is in a lefterly direction, so in theory, lots of reflections of St. Paul's. Essentially, you've got this little gutter line down the middle, which is kind of your middle point. This lens isn't massively wide, so we're just going to do this stood up, and we're going to get St. Paul's, the glass on the left and right, and the sky. Because if we try to get any more than that, it won't work, because lens just not wide enough. Yes, gotta say, very happy with how that came out. It's a little bit wonky, haven't quite nailed the framing, but the colours and the concept both worked, and that's two-thirds of it, so good enough. And so next up is wander a little bit further down the river and start taking some photos of the Shard. We really are going for a tourist in London bingo today. None of the photos in today's video have been particularly original. They've all been photos that I've taken before in spots that I've been to before, but that's a good way to practice with a new camera and to see how similar subjects can come out differently depending on the medium you're photographing them in. At least that's the very convincing excuse I'm sticking to, so deal with it. So of course, next up is the Shard framed between two lampposts. Oh, the sun is absolutely directly above my head now, which is gonna mess with the way that I'm exposing these photos that I'm dropping on the floor, and it's gonna give me the sunburns. And I don't want either of those things to be happening. And how much noise is happening next to me? One of the things I love about city photography is finding external frames. So just shooting for a fence or just something to really draw your eye to a subject. This one I particularly love because the Shard, big triangle, the frame, small triangle. So it lines up quite nicely. Will it work on instant film? Who knows? I mean, we all will. We will all know fairly soon. We are going to go for one more shot of the Shard before we cross back over the river and head to Borough Market to find some shade. Normally, I do that sort of through here with a really wide angle lens. This guy, however, is not wide enough for that. So we're going to try something a little bit different. We're going to go all the way in this corner here, and then between the bridge, the stairs, the river, this wall maybe as well, we should have a little slot where the shard fits. Maybe. Let's try and frame this up. It's just about fits in the frame. It's a little bit too cluttered, just a tiny bit, but I don't know, the concept was cool. This would probably have been one of those times where going portrait would have been better than sticking with landscape, but I still don't like this, so I'm still not going to. I have found a nice spot to just chill in the shade for a few minutes and admire the viscous brown waters of London. Mmm, doesn't it make you want a chocolate milkshake? Okay, I was kind of joking, but an ice cold chocolate milkshake right now sounds amazing. I'm so warm, I'm not built for this heat. So next, we're going to have a little wander through Borough Market. I forgot where I was. I'm not sure how many photo opportunities I'm going to get, but I am enjoying the sheer amount of shade in here. So far, all of the photos have been outside in direct sunlight. So this is technically indoor light. So I don't actually know what the photos are going to be like with indoor light. So this might just be a good opportunity to give that a little testerino and find out. If I'm remembering correctly, which I might not be, there should be a space somewhere in this direction where I can see a big Borough Market sign and also the shard. And that might be a cool photo to remind everyone that I am indeed in London. This is definitely the spot I was thinking of, but is this wide enough to get all of that in? No. What I might do is I might get this shot where you've got just the Borough Market sign. You've got a hint of shard in the background, but it's mostly Borough Market and people. Let's just do that. Right, with the photo taken and slightly underexposed, it's time to get back into the scrum and try and find something cold to drink. It is a fair bit darker in here than I thought it was going to be, but I did get a photograph and it has the words Borough Market in it, so I'm counting that as a win? Question mark? So far today we have ticked off a lot, and I mean like a lot, of the touristy spots in London, but there is still one major one that we haven't seen yet, and that is Tower Bridge. Conveniently, that's exactly where we are, which is why I started recording now. Similar to our St. Paul's shot from earlier, we want to go for something, you know, with some framing. We want to have this monument be the center of our attention. So this little alleyway, street, this, it's not really, it's too big to be an alleyway. So this street leads straight to Tower Bridge. And if you can just about see it at the end there, you have got one of the towers. There's another classic ticked off the list, and of course, so much negative space because, I don't know, I like negative space today, I guess. I am down to my last two shots on this cartridge of film, and I want both of them, I think, to be of Tower Bridge because Tower Bridge is very, very cool. So, this is, you know, one of my favourite spots. Let's go down here and see if this lens is wide enough to take this photo. Okay. No. No, it is not. Let's go find something else to take a photo of. Okay, there is this spot, which is far enough back that I can see the whole of Tower Bridge in the viewfinder. There is a little bit much stuff in the foreground, but, you know, let's give it the old college try, as the Americans say, and see what we can get. Maybe the extra stuff in the foreground will look cool. I don't know. Maybe it'll look too cluttered and look terrible, but there's always the chance that no, it in fact looks good. It's not quite a landmark, but I think this little view of Shad Thames with the bridges along the top, the way the light's being cast, all of the shadow, that feels like a good last instant photo to me. Let's give it a go. As this slowly comes into existence, I'm starting to think that maybe I was in fact right for once, and that was a cool photo to end on. In about 2 minutes or 3 seconds for you, we'll find out. Overall, it's come out a little bit underexposed, but it is cool as heck, so that's fine, I think. That's how that works. At least that's how that works in my head. This has been an absolute powerhouse today. This has been brilliant fun. It's been really simple to use, and the photos have come out fantastically. 10 out of 10. This is my new favorite camera. If you want to see another video with some more details about this lovely and wonderful thing, then let me know and I'll go more in depth. But I'm definitely going to go buy another pack of film and go film another video at some point in the next couple of weeks. So look forward to that. Either way, let's jump back into seeing my face. Thank you very, very much for watching. It is so warm. I am actually melting. I need ice cream and a sandwich, and the sandwich needs to be frozen. Maybe like an ice cream sandwich. What am I talking about? Anyway, bye-bye. Bye-bye. Goodbye. Goodbye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye.